Tourism is a huge driving force behind the city's coffers, and for good reason. New Orleans is home to two professional sports teams, countless amazing restaurants, and never-ending music. So it's only natural that tourism leaders would promote those very things. Joining us live this morning in our studio, we have Mark Roeming of the Tourism and Marketing Corporation to tell us about a new campaign to bring in those visitors, more visitors, right, Mark?
Yes, we need to support and should support the 78,000 people that work in the industry, yes, and to grow more spending into the city, which helps our small businesses. And our new campaign is Follow Your NOLA.
Follow Your NOLA.
It is nationwide. We went live with it last Monday, and it is in 20 markets around the country. And it's really an invitation for people to come and join New Orleans at their own pace and to do things that they enjoy to do. We've got so much here, music, food, architecture, and mm-hmm. the invitation is to come here and spend as much money as they can and stay as long as they want. And our commercial here is now being featured across the country.
Wow.
It features Deacon John. It has the World War II Museum, our architecture, food, Miss Teva on Magazine Street. It's a beautiful commercial.
Absolutely. And when you talk about Follow Your NOLA, when you talk about bringing more visitors to the city, are we targeting a certain type of visitor here? Because we've talked before, I know there is a push to bring younger people to the city.
Well, you know, we are speaking to people that have the same mindset. So mm-hmm. be it either a 24-year-old or a 65-year-old, it's all about giving them an opportunity to explore the music, the food, the architecture. We want the consumer to come and be that responsible tourist that yeah. is spending their money wisely, staying in our hotels, going to our attractions and restaurants. And 91% of our market is the 24 to 65-year-old.
Okay.
Only less than 10% are we speaking to the younger visitor.
And we've set a goal for 2018.
Well, by 2018, if we could reach close to 13.5 million visitors, it's actually 13.7 million visitors, we would have seen about a 33,000 job increase between 2009 and 2018. It's really about the spending. If we can get more dollars into the city, it'll help everything. It, mm-hmm. it helps our small businesses. It provides jobs. And if you look at this, this is really more of a jobs program more than anything else.
Absolutely. Now, let's go back now. A week ago today, mm-hmm. our city experienced a nightmare. 20 people shot, second line, 7th Ward. When you're trying to bring people to this city, that's a story that went national.
Yeah,
how do you overcome a public relations nightmare like that?
First, our thoughts have not been far at all from the victims and their families. So our mindset has been to put our hearts out to those individuals.
Indeed.
We have to maintain the most positive message about New Orleans because it is such a wonderful place. And so if we stop marketing or stop talking about the city of New Orleans, and I think then we cave into the stupidity that brings this forward. So we keep the positive messages forward. We know that the city is a great city to visit. We urge all visitors to use their common sense, obviously, in any city you go to. What we have here is the same situation that occurs in other national urban mm-hmm. centers.
How do you sell the city is safe after something like that?
I think we have to message the fact that that is our number one priority. It's the number one priority for other cities similar to ours, Las Vegas, Chicago, New York, Atlanta. And we have to keep that positive message forward. Plus, as an industry, we work very closely and remain working very closely with the criminal justice system mm-hmm. and the mayor's office to do what we can do to help message that to our visitors as well as our citizens.
And I think the quick arrests after an event like that helps.
I think the turnaround and being able to find the perpetrators and bring them mm-hmm. to justice is a good sign that you send around not only to our citizens but also to the nation that we mean business about this.
Summer numbers.
Well, you know, we've got a great summer starting already, and mm-hmm. of course, the cornerstone in the middle of the summer is our Essence Festival. But we have the New Orleans
Looking
Food and Wine Experience. We have Satchmo Fest. We have White Linen Night. We've got Tales of the Cocktail. We've got Bastille Day. The summer has really developed into a wonderful place to visit, and it's a great place for families.
So the bottom line here, follow your NOLA.
Follow your NOLA. Come on and enjoy New Orleans and really enjoy the city like us locals do.
Absolutely. Mark Roeming, thank you so much for being
Always
here.
Always a pleasure.